The Bewitching of Merlin. Tree, raven, eel, cat, God's bones, Nimue, the Morrigan, Vivian, Morgana, separate but intertwined, like a nest of vipers. Poor befuddled Merlin. He tries to impress her with a few simple tricks, and she laps it up like a glacial English mountain lion. She takes that sprinkling and forms a feast. Magic within magic, layers of enchantment as thick as a multi-bird roast. Slice into her pie and outfly a host of songbirds. You've been outfoxed, Merlin, siren called. Seaborn Morgana, cross-legged in sunken lioness. So still, breath held, eyes closed, only bubbles escape from her lips. She is held. Like a rock, she is not rocked by the comforting constants of the sea, but anchored by her silent breath. Oysters for eyes, she waits and she waits, and if you wait long enough. Eyes splash open and she kicks her way to the surface, sword in hand, offering herself up, tempting the sailors and knights and magicians with her siren shrieks. She kisses goodbye to underwater secrets, untold treasures, unopened chests, and finds the surface again. Poor Merlin. Poor befuddled Merlin, grown slow and unpracticed through vanity and laurel rest. Son of the devil himself, he leaned to that laconic edge. So many years. So many stolen years in a cave of his own making. There have been several lifetimes shrouded in stone, sprinkled occasionally with the many languages of love, but in creeps sadness and deadening familiarity, and all that is left are the embroidery and denials of memory, a forward winding, pausing, zooming in and out. But now we can sink down. We can watch, fish-eyed, forward wound into the future as we are. We can watch the stillness of that little sunken treasure chest, the slimy sweetness as the moss grows over. There is time, here in the slow motion of the underworld, there is time to grow, to unravel submarine secrets, to watch it all start again.